Welcome to Scripture Snippets. Today we're continuing Philippians chapter 3, verses 1 to 6. And today's message is titled, Rejoice in the Lord. So let's dig in, verse 1. Finally, my brethren, rejoice in the Lord. For me to write the same things to you is not tedious, but for you it is safe. Paul loves writing about rejoicing in the Lord to the Philippians. He uses the word chairo, which is rejoice, 10 times in this letter to the Philippians. Apparently, he wants to get the point across that our relationship with Christ should be one of joy and rejoicing because all of the good things he's done for us. So let's read on. Verse 2. Beware of dogs. Beware of evil workers. Beware of the mutilation. For we are the circumcision, who worship God in the Spirit. Rejoice in Christ Jesus and have no confidence in the flesh. He means religion and religious activity. Though I also might have confidence in the flesh, if anyone else thinks he may have confidence in the flesh, I more so, circumcised the eighth day, of the stock of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, Hebrew of the Hebrews, concerning the law of Pharisee, concerning zeal, persecuting the church, concerning the righteousness which is in the law, blameless. So you see, Paul knows what it's like to be working diligently and zealously to earn favor with God, to earn merit with God, to earn holiness with God. But the word says that our righteousness apart from Christ is like filthy rags. You can't earn salvation. You can't earn righteousness. And Paul knows what it's like to be striving and striving to be holy and yet have a Christless life. And so he's warning the Philippians that people are going to try to convert them to a religious system, trying to pollute the simplicity of the grace of Jesus Christ, the simplicity of forgiveness only through one, Jesus Christ, because he is the ultimate sacrifice for our sins. And so, brothers and sisters, don't get caught up in the things you're not doing right. Get caught up in who Jesus is, because, you know, Jesus is always right. And when we keep our eyes fixed on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, he will make us his righteousness. We will live like him because we're keeping our eyes fixed on him. We are keeping our heart resting in who Jesus is. So don't strive for righteousness. Don't strive for holiness. Don't allow someone to put a guilt trip or a shame on you. Instead, celebrate and rejoice the freedom that Jesus Christ has given you. God bless you guys. Rejoice in the Lord always.